This is don't power on now, so we will power in it later. So first of all, we need a disk. For RAID 5, we need a 3 disk minimum. So I'm adding a 3 disk here. So add, cancel it. I'm increase this one. So this is my server. Edit virtual machine settings. Okay, so here is my virtual machine settings. I'm going to add. So click on add. Okay, so hard disk. Next, select iSCSI. I'm selecting iSCSI. Next, new virtual hard disk. We have to go. Next, store virtual hard disk as a single file. Store virtual hard disk of single file. Here is a 160. I'm putting 160. You can take 100 also. 100 is good. Actually, if you take 100, is look good. I'm taking 100. Yesterday I took 160. Okay, it is giving some different name. Okay, so I will go back to use existing virtual hard disk. Actually, you have to create a new hard disk. One second, guys. So I done mistake. Yesterday I created some disk, right? So probably the naming thing is issue by from there only. Where is my virtual machine? In a H drive. So that's why locations are important to understand. See these three disks yesterday I created. I don't want this disk. I'll delete this disk. I'm deleting this one, so I don't want that one. I'll create a new disk, right? Guys, can you see LOC? So sorry, LCK. Whenever you see in your place like a LCK, don't worry, just leave it, no problem. Okay, it's not, it won't give you any problem until unless if you got a problem. Okay, you got a problem, something like machine not at all open. Okay, like this one, take ownership kind of error. Even though you restart a PC, log out, log in, everything, you will get some error. Last time someone got the error. I didn't remember who got the error also. Okay. If you got the that kind of error, no, sometimes you have to delete those kind of LCK files. I deleted it and it worked. So last time who got that error, I don't know. Okay,
I think I got that error, Aditya.
Aditya, right, okay. I'll show you that. Okay. I think I saved your name, but where it is gone?
It's gone up, down little bit.
Salman. Yeah, now, so, yeah, here it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, there it is.
Yeah. Same kind of error only. So same thing, you will get a take ownership. Okay, but you got like this. So I checked everything, but I didn't find any backend opening. So what I done, so I go to the virtual machine part. Okay, then I deleted these LCK files, but when it's running, don't do it, but it is locked. Even if you are restart your PC, also it is not releasing that one. So what you will do, just delete these things. Okay, it not my solution also, it is from Google search only. Okay, good. So you know, practice, you will get a lot of errors. Try to solve it, you will get a lot of knowledge. you know, I solved almost like a 3-4 members very big problem. You know what is the biggest problem in nowadays? VPN connection for people who are working from home. You know, they're working in a main home, means main city, like they are working in a Pune. Okay, work from home for Pune. Now they are moved to their village. They're connected to internet. Now VPN is not connecting. It has happened to my sister. I searched for that one, and finally I find a solution. It's a very small, very, very small thing only. Just I given a solution and it is working. She told to her manager and another manager also, like, so she took care remotely, like, do like this. So that's why. So she solved 2-3 people problem also. Same problem. They are also getting VPN is not connecting. VPN is connecting. When they are connected to VPN, normal internet is stopped. They are connected to VPN. VPN is working, but a normal internet is not working. So if normal internet not working, means they can't work on other systems. Okay. So they have to work on only VPN part only. They cannot work on remaining things, remaining connections, remaining remote sessions. It won't open. Remote desktops are not open. Okay. So it's more complex to work. So what happened here? So I told her a solution. I don't get how to solve that one. Okay. So I search in a Google, and I thought it is a very funny. Okay. You know what is the funniest thing? I will show you that solution also, even in a record no problem. I thought when I read the solution, I thought it is very funny. Okay, because of what he said, go to your connection, means usually we use a Wi-Fi, right? So go to Wi-Fi properties, disable IPv6, uncheck this IPv6. That's it. I feel very funny, like, if you disable IPv6, how come your VPN is connected, and as well as the internet is also connected? Okay, when they connected to VPN through internet, and when after connection of I connected VPN through internet, understand? Now VPN is connected, the remote session is connected, but actual internet, I can't able to access the actual internet, means I can't open Amazon.com or Flipkart.com or anything. Only company remote connection only I can able to open it. So that's the problem they are facing. But they need both the things for work only. Mail communication and all, they need a communication. So they didn't getting. And I search for a solution. I find this solution. I feel it is very funny. But I tried it. It's worked. It worked for almost 3-4 members directly. Okay. So, you know, sometimes try, you will find lot of solutions. You have to don't study and do as it is. Do whatever it is, because it's a virtual machine mainly. In a first target is virtual machine part. Okay. Do whatever it is. Something is happened, find out the solution. Then how you become a troubleshooter, right? Okay guys, we'll go to add a 3 hard disk here. So edit virtual machine settings. Okay, I'm adding add disk. I hope you can able to see clearly. Next, SCSI. Next, new virtual hard disk. Single file, and I put a 100 instead of 160. Now this I put a 100. Any size you can take it. Now it is showing 0. Finish it. Okay. So I want to show you, like, feel like it is from starting only, right? That's why I need a 3 disk. So added a 3 disk. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3. If you want to change anything in this disk, also we can change it here, from here. Expand, advance, things are there. Okay. 3 disk I added. Don't worry, 100 GB means you don't require 100 GB in your physical machine. It's a virtual hard disk only. Okay. Now 3 disk are added. I start my virtual machine. Let it start. First, I will show you the RAID 0, RAID 1, RAID 2, like that. Let it start. Then we'll see. No. My virtual machine. I want my virtual machine. Okay. So it will take time to start. Okay. Anyway, lot of labs are there, guys. I think most of you learn how to install a virtual machine, how to create a virtual machine, how to install an operating system in virtual machine. That is important only. How to install an operating system. That's a thing. Like, you know Windows 10 how to install, we know Windows Server how to install, and you know how to install a Linux anyway. Okay. So you can, when you are a time, then you can try easily. Anything you can do. Prajwal Desai. He's also created a lot of labs in a system. See, he has his own blog, prajwaldesai.com. Okay. So SCCM server. Okay. SCCM. Prajwal Desai. Okay, Microsoft related things. See, Microsoft related things, cloud related things. Okay, software, right? So many things he created. He's the person, I think. Okay, so his name is Prajwal Desai. Okay, like so many digital ocean is a cloud service provider, and as well as the digital ocean also notes also there. So take it, any technology, try install in a virtual machines, do it. Okay, it is open finally. Admin @123. In server, so many things to learn is there. For example, I log in as an administrator, right? Can I log in as a different user? Like that, so many things are. Okay, so now server manager is also going to be open anyway, but we don't need the server manager. Let it open server manager itself. We don't worry about it. The first one is disk management, diskmgmt.msc. disk management directly I have opened. Disk management. Put it in a full screen mode. Minimize this one, we don't need this one. You need some, okay, not required. I got a problem because when system is running, if I add the disk, then it disk will add into 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what happened? It make my disk into third disk. Original disk become third disk, and these disks become first disk. Disk 0, disk 1, disk 2, like this. Okay, I will increase the this one. See, can you see? It is actually, this is my actual original disk. This should be disk 0, but logically it is changed to disk 1, disk 2, disk 3. Sorry, disk 0, disk 1, disk 2. 100 GB, 100 GB, 100 GB, 3 disk. Okay, now This is yesterday notes, right? So yesterday what we discussed, based on that we will see. First one is right zero. Guys, anybody tell what is right zero? Faster. You don't have time. Yes, it's a stripped set. Two disc volume.
Without pen.
If disc is failure, total data loss. Okay. So first we'll do disc zero, write zero. And initially we have to make it everything is online. So we need a two disc, right? Minimum two disc we required. Okay. So I put every three are in online. This is not initialize. I am initializing this one. Initialize the disk, GPT, all three disk GPT. So all our check mark is there. All our GPT disk only now. Okay. So I can put MBR also, no problem. Now this is the black one, right? So the first is unallocated. I am going to disk zero, unallocated. Right click, stripped volume. I'm going to stripped volume. I'm not going to span. Stripped volume is actually right zero. Stripped volume. And it is showing what is a stripped volume. Stripped volume store data in a strips on two or more disk. A stripped volume give you a faster access to your data than a simple or a spanned volume. Simple or a spanned volume. Now, how many disk you want to add it? You can add all the other disk also like this, and like this also you can add it. So it become a 30 GB data. So two or more disk we can use it. Two or more disk we can use it. Okay. So you can use three also, no problem. But I will remove three. Only two disk I'm using. This is the total disk space. I'm doing this practical very plainly. Okay. So adjust any name, quick format, next, finish. It is throwing an error. If you read it, this you can see. Operation you selected will convert the selected basic disk to dynamic disk. If you convert a disk to dynamic, you will not be able to start install operating system from any volume on the disk. Except the current boot volume, you are you want to continue? Yes. What is that meaning? The disk is basic disk earlier. So if you see, disk is basic disk. Now it is convert into dynamic disk. First it will convert into dynamic disk, then only it will convert into, it will do RAID levels. Okay, if you are now you combine the disk, when you're combining two disk as a single volume, two disk as a single volume, so okay, so yeah, it is showing F drive. So we require a convert into dynamic. When you combining two or more disk into the volumes, you have to convert from basic to dynamic. If you are not converted, system will convert automatically. Generally we have to convert earlier. So can you see, this is F drive, this is F drive. Okay, and this is also F drive. See, both are having a F drive only. F drive, stripped, dynamic, NTFS, healthy, 200 GB disk. So you can see, right click, open. This is F drive. So you can see F drive. I'm creating some data here. Data means anything. Okay, so I created some data. So this PC, you can see F drive 200 GB. Okay, now I'm going to here. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to disk one, right click, offline. I'm making it is offline. Okay, just offline. One disk is offline. So then what happened? Failed. One disk is offline, failed. See? So we can reactivate the disk. try. Even still not running. Reactivate the volume. No, it is not running. Only one. You have to online this one. Meanwhile, I will want to show you one thing. Okay. Where is F drive? F drive is gone from here. F drive is gone from here. Okay. So that is. Now I am going to. Just I made it offline only. I didn't remove the disk. If I remove the disk, it cannot come. Okay. So automatically it is reactivated. Just I made it offline only. That's it. If I remove the hard disk, it total loss. Okay. That's it. So now you can see open. Okay. Like this. Data is there. Just because of I made it offline only. I didn't remove the disk. I didn't change the disk. Okay. If I remove the disk, for example, right click here, delete volume, completely deleted. Now no F drive, nothing. It's become a basic disk also. Okay, this is a basic. Don't try on your physical machine, guys. So don't try this thing like a convert into dynamic disk and all. Later, if you ask, I don't know solution. Like some people convert thing. Okay. So, try it on only virtual machines, that to server only. Okay. So this is a stripped volume. So we combine 100 GB, 100 GB, we got a 200 GB volume. That's it. Now RAID 1. What is RAID 1? Tell me RAID 1. What is RAID 1?
Mirror volume.
How many days?
2 weeks.
And what is the mirrored volume?
One disk is failure, still we can able to access the data.
Very good. So it is called as single disk failure without parity. So we'll do that mirror disk, right? So we need a 2 disk. So here right click mirrored. So it is also showing mirror volume, duplicate your data on 2 disk. Create a mirror volume if you want to keep 2 separate copies of all information to prevent data loss. Okay. So next I'm adding either of the disk, first disk only, like that. So I can't add the second one. So we have to take only 2 disks. We can't add a third disk here. Next. 2 disk I have taken, this one, instead of new I put a mirror. It is not mandatory, you can use a new volume, a new only, volume 1, anything, no problem. And it is not converting to dynamic, so I am converting dynamic directly. Okay, so it is converted into dynamic first, then it is formatting. See the colors, the color represent mirrored volume. Okay, if you have any desktop which is used for a normal office work, very important data is there, then you can create a mirror volume. But be careful with that. Okay, so F drive. Can you see this is F drive? This is F drive, right? 100 GB plus 100 GB equal to 100 GB here. See? Okay, 100 GB. Okay. F drive 100 GB. Why? Because if one disk is failure, no problem, other disk has a data. So I'm right click, go to open. If this is F drive, so our previous data is deleted, so don't worry about it. Okay, because disk volume is deleted, then automatically data also lost. Create some folder. Because of this zoom, na? So okay, I put something. Remember, we have some files for that one. Okay, bitmap also, one bitmap. Okay, so something I put it in a F drive. So this PC, you can see F drive 100 GB, and this is my data. Okay, so I'm going back to this PC. Now I have a F drive, So 100 plus 100, and this is a 100 GB. And what is the rule here? If any disk is failure, still we can able to access the data without parity. Now I make it this one as a offline, just offline only. Okay, I make this one as a offline. Now fail redundancy. Okay, no problem. So this PC, still F drive is there. Maybe it is forget, so refresh. See, F drive is there. F drive data is also there. It means what happened? Even one of the disk is become offline, still we can able to access the data. Okay. If it is online, it is works back again. So I will show you here. Reactivate the disk is there. So this is offline, online. So data is safe, but I make this one online. Now it is become foreign. It become a foreign disk. So import a foreign disk. Okay. So we'll try something. Can you see it is? This is become F drive. This is become G drive. Both are having a same data. Both are having a same data because of I am using same disk because it's a once it is offline, that's it. But if you add some data to one of the thing, for example F drive, I'm going to F drive, I'm adding some data here. Why? I will copy this data and I paste this data directly. Now see, little bit length of the data increases, right? And you know, G drive also created. See, earlier only F drive and second one become G drive. It's not affected, it is having previous data only. I use only single disk on this. I didn't replace the disk. If I replace the disk, then data won't be there. But what happened here? Observe. Earlier, both are combinedly F drive. Now it is F drive and this is G drive. It means separate. What happened? Mirror is broken. It is showing simple. Can you see it is showing simple and mirror? The name is changed and properties changed. Simple volume. So you see the gray color. So this is green color. It's a simple volume. It's not mirrored volume. It is simple volume. Okay. This become a normal simple volume only. Separate disk. Mirror got broken because it's online offline kind of stuff. Even if I delete G drive, I'm deleting G. Still I have a F drive. So no relationship between disk 0 to disk 1. So this is your RAID 1. RAID 1 means mirror volume. Now tell me about RAID 5. How many disks we require? Three disks we required. Single disk failure without parity. Bye guys, you are not speaking. How much space we will get it? Faster. Okay, total volume 2 by 3 of the size means 3 disk is equal to 2 disk size. One disk is failure, no volume, still we can able to access the data. If disk is replaced and data is regenerated in new disk. So this is the properties of RAID 5. Practically we'll see that one. We need a 3 disk. Okay, so you can convert this disk dynamically directly. You can convert dynamic disk directly, or you can use directly, no volume, anything. Okay, right click, new RAID 5 volume. RAID 5 volume store data in a strips on 3 or more disk. It provide a way of recovering data if part of data is lost. So understand this one. So RAID 5 volume store data in a strips on 3 or more disk. It provide a way of recovering data if part of data is lost. Okay, it will recover the data easily. You can use 3 disk or 3 or more, like you can use 4 disk also, 5 disk also, like that. Okay, I am using 3 disk only in this practical, so 3 disk you can I'm using. Next. Okay, I'm putting a RAID5 volume, quick fire format, compulsory quick format, and converting dynamic, yes, and wait. First it is convert basic disk to dynamic disk. It will take time, 100 GB, right? So it is taking too much time. I will verify this. Okay, it is taking time. I don't have more weight on this one. So much time it is taking. Okay, so meantime I'm gonna repeat this thing. Okay, first RAID 0 stripped volume, RAID 1 mirror. This is RAID 5. So RAID 5 only. So RAID 0. Combine a disk and become it create a huge volume size. But no disk value. So if any disk value, data total data loss. Mirror. 2 disk we are using. If 1 disk is failure, still we can able to access the data, but mirror will be broke after your disk is online again, the failed disk online again. Okay, mirror will be broke again. We have to create the mirror. So RAID 5. So it is now. Why it is taking that much of time? I don't know. RAID 5 is very quick also. Okay, so it is taking this much time. I don't know. Okay. So can you able to view, right? So this is a RAID 5. So this is the F drive RAID 5. So can you see? It's showing 200 GB. But I combine 300 GB. Oh, okay, 3 disk means 300 GB. But volume size is 200 GB only. So all are F drives only. So we'll go to this PC server. So we'll go to 160. See, 200 GB. Now the volume is deleted earlier, so we don't have a data. So I'm going to create some data here. Okay, no problem. Some files. Okay, so I created some data here in a F drive. Okay, so F drive, can you see it is a 200 GB disk. Now I'm going to this F drive. So again, one of the disk, I make it into offline. So I'm selecting the first disk or second disk, anything, no problem. So right click, I make it is offline only, just for our understanding only. Actually, we have to remove the disk and test it also. Now, what happened when I make one of the disk is offline, failed redundancy. One of the disk is offline, failed redundancy. These two are online, but it is showing failed redundancy and it is showing some mark also. No problem. So you have still have a F drive. So I have a data. Still have a F drive. I have a data. See, F drive. I have a data. Okay. So as first statement, if you lost one disk, still we can able to have a data, right? And now, if you reconnect the disk back, it regenerate the data. Okay, so for example, okay, so open not showing, but if in case I have extra data is there. Now see, more data is there, right? More data is there. So this disk don't know about the extra data, but it will regenerate the extra data here once it is become online and reconcile that one. So see guys, carefully, I'm making this disk online, but still showing warning and as well as a fail redundancy also. Showing fail redundancy. No problem. Right click, reactivate the disk. Again, it is taking time. You know, that is the difference between Linux and Windows. Linux, less services running in background. Windows, the graphic services will consume more RAM and other services also. So it is taking time. Again, we have to give some time to reconcile that. Resume. So now we got it back. It is taking time. Now, three disks are there. Everything is healthy. Can you see this is still F drive only? After I make this one offline and reactivate the disk, it is there. And if you open this disk, anyway, it is F drive. It contains same data only. Okay, so no balance. This is the same F drive. You didn't miss the disk. You didn't get another disk like a mirror. So that is the difference between your mirror and RAID 5, because it's having a parity bit. So F drive, still it is there. And this disk, even if it is become offline, we can able to access data. And if it is become online again, okay, and automatically it is joined into RAID 5. The disk is not broken into the volume. Okay, so it is not broken like a mirror is broken. So it's not like that. RAID 5 is not broken. It is reconcile the RAID 5 directly and reconfigured and regenerate the data in the disk. Okay, so this is about your RAID 5. Okay, so this is how we can do practical part. So I'm